Hey, what's going on guys? Rahul here from Tech Repro and welcome back to another episode. Pixelmator has just released its iPad exclusive photo editor app named Pixelmator Photo. So in this video, I'll review Pixelmator Photo app and also guide you with the complete tutorial about how to use Pixelmator Photo editor app to enhance your images. Pixelmator has been one of the most popular photo editor app for Mac. It's often considered as a Photoshop alternative. Currently, Pixelmator is available for macOS as well as iOS, so you may download it on your iPhone as well as iPad. Back in 2017, Pixelmator released an upgraded version of its Pixelmator Photo Editor app and named it Pixelmator Pro. Pixelmator Pro is yet another powerful photo editor app for Mac. But Pixelmator Pro is not yet available for iOS, meaning you can't download Pixelmator Pro on iPhone or iPad. I was expecting that Pixelmator will release Pixelmator Pro upgraded version for iPhone or iPad as well. But Pixelmator completely surprised me by releasing a new app with name Pixelmator Photo. Pixelmator Photo is currently available in the App Store and you can download it on your iPad. So let's download it and check out how powerful this Pixelmator Photo editor app is. Alright. Now I have downloaded Pixelmator Photo app on my iPad and now let's open it. Welcome to Pixelmator Photo. Easily turn any good photo spectacular using the extensive collection of powerful editing tools in Pixelmator Photo. Get started by opening an image on your iPad or import a photo from your photos library. As you can see, Pixelmator is pretty explanatory itself. So I'll tap continue. And here we get two options. Tap plus to import an image from your photos library, or tap browse to browse and open images on your iPad in iCloud and other location. Since I have already images in my gallery, so I'll simply tap on this plus sign and then Pixelmator would like to access my photos. I'll allow the permission and here I can select images that I want to enhance in Pixelmator Photo. I'll choose this one and tap on import and this will import this image back in Pixelmator Photo. Alright, this is our canvas. We can pinch it or zoom and resize. Here on the left we have navigation and here on the right we have tools. First let's start with ML. ML is just like magic wand tool in original Pixelmator. And this uses machine learning and artificial intelligence to enhance your images. So I'll simply tap this and let's see what kind of enhancement it does. It's pretty good. Alright, if I like this, I can keep it or I can revert back to original. Or also I can undo to come back to the enhanced version with machine learning. Alright, I'll go back to the files and choose another image. Let's choose this one. And here it has been already enhanced by machine learning. You can see that ML tool is active here. If I disable ML, it will come to its original version. Next we have repair tool. Repair tool basically helps you remove unwanted elements from your images. For example, if I want to remove this monkey, I'll simply tap on this repair tool and then adjust my size for repair. I select the range and once selected, I release it. And as soon as I release, it will remove this monkey from this image. Alright, now coming on to the next tool, we have crop tool. And it provides us option to crop and resize the image. We may manually adjust the corners to crop it to our preferred size or we may also use the ML crop option, which uses machine learning and artificial intelligence to crop the image. If you like the ML crop, we can keep it or if not, we can reset it and it will come back to its original size. Here we also get other options for cropping. For example, this is crop option, this is straighten. This is perspective transform. If you don't know what is straighten, we can adjust this to change the angle of the image. I'll get it back to 0. And come back. Here we have another option, perspective. Perspective lets us change the angle of the corners. I'll go back and reset this. Here we have more crop options. We can choose the aspect ratio like original, square size. This is good for Instagram. 4:5, 16:9, 9:16, 4:3, 3:4, 3:2, 2:3, and also custom size. I'll cancel it and come to original option. Here we also get other options like rotating it and flipping it. Alright, this is the crop tool in Pixelmator Photo app. And next tool we have is image enhancement tool. And this basically lets you enhance your image's white balance, hue and saturation, lightness, and many more options like contrast, color balance, etc. You can adjust the temperature, tint, hue, saturation, vibrance, exposure, shadow, brightness, and much more. I'll reset the adjustment and this will come to the original. Here in the bottom, we get many presets for the color balance of an image in Pixelmator Photo. For example, we have got black and white presets like this, cinematic presets, and classic films preset. Modern film presets, landscape presets, vintage presets, which provides you a cool vintage look. Then urban presets, created for urban photography. And many more presets. If you want, you may also adjust the white balance of any presets manually. And once you like the adjustments, you may tap the share button to share it to your preferred places. For example, here we get three shared options: modify original in photos, save copy to photos, and export options. There are minor differences between the three. For example, modify original in photos will modify the original photo with the edited version. If you want, you may also revert back to the original photos from the options. And if you choose save copy to photos, it will simply save a copy of this image in your photos library while leaving the original photo untouched. However, the third option is export option, and export option is particularly good if you want to choose your preferred option for exporting. For example, here you get various exporting options, like you can choose the file extension HIEF, JPEG, PNG, TIFF, photo, and also adjust the quality of the image. For example, if I choose PNG, the file size will come to 717 KB. However, if I go back to JPEG, I can adjust the quality of the image, and as I increase the quality, it'll increase the file size as well. Once done with all the settings, I can tap on next, and this will ask me where I want to save this image. I'll choose to save images, and this will save to my photos library. Next we have menu options. If I tap the three dot here I get the functionality to enable status bar, which will show the time and date status of your iPad. I disable it, and then auto center canvas, histogram, extended value, show info. Show info will basically show the information about the image. For example, lens information and date of image, etc. If you get stuck somewhere and need help, you may tap on this Pixelmator Photo help option to get referenced knowledge base articles. And next, we have last option is support, which basically takes you to the Pixelmator official website for support. I especially like the ML enhanced feature of this Pixelmator Photo app. However, it lacks many crucial options like adding text on the image and many more. If you want, you may purchase it right now from App Store for just under $4, and if you act early, you will also get a 20% off. So that's pretty much all about Pixelmator Photo tutorial. If you enjoyed watching this tutorial, please hit the like button and share with your friends. And if you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. I'll be happy to help. Thanks for watching. I'm Rahul signing off, and I'll see you in the next one.